are exploring a massive collection of abandoned American cars. Look at the moss growing all over this car. Look at this old AMC. I've just found a Mustang. Look how this tree has completely squashed this car. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome to a brand new video. So, I'm back with the gang again. Today we have come to have a look at the American car graveyard. Now apparently there is a lot of cars in here. The main man is going to give me a tour around the place.
It's unreal, absolutely unprecedented. You feel like you're in America.
I can't wait.
All the American viewers that watch my man's channel, you're going to be at home.
I cannot wait, I really can't. Okay, so we're just making our way through the woods. I can see something over there. Yeah. Okay, so I think as soon as we get over this hill, we're going to have a better idea of what we're looking at today. Oh my God. Oh my God. This is incredible. Oh, wow. This is unreal. This is unreal. There must be about 300 cars here at least. Wow. I don't know where to start. I mean, yeah. Oh, incredible. Absolutely incredible. You're right, it is like being in America. It really is. Yeah. God. I mean, some of these are just... Oh, I'm speechless. I really am speechless. Well done, mate. All right, let's go and check them out. It is like being in an American junkyard. That's unbelievable. Wow. Oh my God.
It's a fucking find, isn't it?
How long have these cars been here for, really?
60, 50, 60 years.
At least.
Yeah. Most of these cars are some of late 50s, 60s and 70s. That's what I mean. When I come around here, it's like you need to spend at least fucking a good day.
Yeah, that much. Yeah, there is. There really is.
This is definitely
before
I come back to.
This is an AMC. Yeah, that's a company. AMC is The Walking Dead. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's unreal. How is that even possible? Stu was just saying that the tree's fallen on the car, but it hasn't even broken the window. I would say American build quality, but they're not really that good, aren't they? We won't go there.
No comment.
No comment. Do you know, I cannot believe that the tree hasn't broken this window. And you think how much weight's on it. It doesn't move at all. It's completely wedged. I mean, how long has that tree been on top of that car? Oh, my I honestly feel like I'm in America right now. I really do. I think Stu's right. Most of these cars have been here for about 50 or 60 years. I mean, there's not a great deal that could be saved on them, really, when you look at them closely. The bonnets, I mean, the windows, most of the windows are still good, but all the panels are rotten. Most of them are rotten. No, it's as far as you can see. There are just cars everywhere. My goodness me. Look, this car has actually become part of the tree. Like, the tree has actually started to grow around the car. And the same with this one here as well. The front of the car is actually stuck inside the tree. Okay, so we're going to move a little bit deeper into this location. Look at the moss on this car. Joe, it is actually like artwork, it really is. It's so amazing. Stu's right, you could spend easily a whole day looking through these cars. I mean, look, they must have been worth a fortune. But it's a shame because they're probably not, I mean, even scrap, where they're so rotten, there's not much good metal left on them. It's pretty cool. Is that a starlet? It looks like a starlet. Wow. Honestly, I don't know where to look. I honestly don't know where to look. But guys, you are going to have to help me. This is called a metro. You are going to have to help me because a lot of these cars, I don't know the exact names and models for them. So as I'm walking through, if you can just drop it in the comments below, the make of the car and the colour, just so I've got a better idea of what I'm looking at. Incredible, it really is. I mean, that there looks like a Camaro. Oh my god. This is unbelievable. Look at all these drums in here. I've got some suspension springs down the bottom. Looks like an old patrol car there. This must have been like a breaker's yard for American cars. It has to have been. It looks like the Ghostbusters car there. It looks like the Ghostbusters car there. Oh, these brambles are a nightmare. Ugh. Feel like it's a breaker's yard, doesn't it? Like an old American breaker's yard. But like I say, no one's been here for years.
The train dam's up there, the one up there, and there's a couple down there, but the one up there's a heartbreaker.
That boy's quite cool.
It's got over there, where the Impala is, it's got like proper old school 80s crosses, loads of them. Shitloads of them.
Amazing.
Yeah,
absolutely amazing.
Just one of them.
Just one.
It's overwhelming, isn't it?
It is. Honestly, I don't know where to look. I really don't. How smart is that bumper there?
I know, proper chrome.
Yeah. God. Right, let's move on. Okay, so Stu's just going to show me a very special car. He hasn't told me what it is yet. I cannot wait to see it.
The greatest Mustang, but it's still a Mustang.
Do you know what? My friend's got one of these. Yeah. Oh my God. He is going to hate me. Those wheels are pretty cool.
What wast?
Yeah. Do you know what? It's got patina.
Yeah, patina's mod.
Yeah. And it's not rotten.
No. You can tell with that type of patina, that's been baked. So this has come from basically California somewhere. And it's come straight here to sit.
It's crazy, isn't it?
Three parts car. You would not start that motorbike, mate.
A kickstart. 500cc board.
500cc.
Yeah.
Break your ankle, that, wouldn't it? That is a cool bike. That is a really, really cool bike. That is not Trans Am. Oh my god. Wow.
And there's two Trans Ams over there. Equally the same condition.
Really?
Yeah.
Just said earlier, it's a shame because a lot of the stuff probably can't be saved now where it's so rotten.
No.
Things like the lights, I mean, even the brackets holding them on are probably knackered. You know, the glass.
But all this covered in cars too.
Yeah, there's everything, yeah. Oh my god.
Can I walk around the back here, bro? This is the back of these cars, so it's easy to access. You can just see a better picture.
Okay, cool. Okay, so we're just taking a walk around the outside of the main collection of cars, which is here. That's a funny little thing there. I don't know what that is. Do you know what that is?
No.
Guys, if you know what car this is, please just pop it in the comments below. Grand AM part next to it. And look at this. Look at these containers. They're just absolutely full of car parts. Look at all the exhausts in there. It's a shame because, I mean, there's probably people out there crying for this stuff. And they've got no idea that it's here. Look at all the wheels.
Like this
right
here.
Oh my god, does it? Oh my god. It's starting to get a bit dark here, which is a shame, so we'll have to try and get this video done quick. But try and not rush it too much. Gosh, she's a big girl, isn't she?
She is, yeah.
Look at the size of that.
Do you remember the gremlin?
Yeah.
This isn't a gremlin, but it's on the same car. This is, we've got a Monte Carlo over there.
Oh, yeah.
Rare
look
cars
at that.
There. But look at this hippie with this van here. Look. That's definitely 70s.
Oh,
Americana.
That is absolutely awesome, isn't it?
Black. Dodge that is.
Yeah, I've seen a few of them, old patrol cars.
Yeah.
Oh, this is awesome. Oh, wow. That's still got the kitchen sink and everything in there. Another AMC. Yeah.
Compact cars.
Buick.
Yeah, Buick, yeah. I think it's a Buick LeSabre, I think. But your view is more correct, John. Over there. I think it's a Stingray.
A Corvette Stingray?
I think it is.
Seriously?
Are you telling me there's a Corvette Stingray over there?
Yeah. It looks the same body. Have a little step over there.
Right, I'm going to have to have a look at this. I'm going to have to have a look.
I'm pretty sure it's a Stingray for the back end of it.
Oh, right, without cutting myself and breaking my neck.
It looks like
you are right.
That is rare, that is.
How long do you think that's been there?
The only thing that makes me question it is they're all fiberglass.
Yeah.
Aren't they? I'm pretty sure they're all fiberglass Stingrays, aren't they?
Do you know, I'm not 100% sure on
pretty
that.
Pretty sure they're fiberglass.
Yeah.
Because that's why like you see a lot of like, you see the American car programs, you always see these Stingrays just
immaculate. Yeah, there's no rot in them, is there?
So
either
that's smashed to pieces or it's rotted.
Yeah.
That's what makes me think, is it a Stingray? It might even be a Trans Am.
It could be.
The back end sloped, isn't it?
Could be. Guys, there's probably some of you out there that know exactly what that car is. Please, like before, just pop it in the comments below. Absolutely incredible. I mean, these cars are so rare. And it's criminal that they're all sat here rotting away, isn't it? It really is.
Gorgeous little AMC.
Yeah.
What's the film with when they're doing the meth amphetamine? I think you drove the AMC, when you
didn't
you?
Right. Yeah, yeah.
Boogie.
That's a good number plate, I like that. I've got to have a look at this patrol car because there's still some writing on the side of it. Oh, I can't quite read it. It says at the bottom for official use only, United States of America. But I can't read where it's come from. Damn. Guys, if you can recognise that, and have any idea where this patrol car's come from, please just pop it in the comments below. I think this is the third one I've seen here now. God, I don't even see these ones here. They're just popping out from everywhere. Looks good with the old police badge on the back of it. Oh, look at this. It's a shame this is rotted so badly. It's quite a cool looking thing. And it's just literally falling into the ground. I'm just going to see if I can get a bit closer to that car over here. Stu thought was a stingray. America 1982, Walton Park, Nottingham. It could be. I'm looking at the mirror. I think that is a Trans Am.
Trans Am, yeah. Or maybe think it was the stingray because the back looks.
Yeah, yeah, you are right.
They got wide arches, haven't they?
Oh my gosh, there's more cars parked next to it.
Yeah, there's loads of them.
I didn't even see those. And a massive lorry there. This is overwhelming. It really is. Right, let's try and see if we can grab some more before it gets too dark. Okay, so we're gonna walk around a little bit further. Oh, let's see what other cars we can find here. That's the front of that patrol car there. Probably one of my favourites here. I've always liked the old American patrol cars. Caprice Classic. They're big old cars, these. It's almost like walking around Rush Valley. Look at this old truck. There is so many here. So many. Oh. Do you know what? I've just got a thorn and it's gone right into my finger. Oh. That really hurt. But it's all part of the game. Oh, there we go. Oh, I've got no idea what this was. They've completely cut the roof off of it. God. Ooh. Catch up with the others. I'm not sure where they've gone. I think they've gone back to the front. I'm pretty sure that's a Firebird. With the wing badge on the side of it. Ooh. Pretty cool car. There's not much left of that one, sadly. Right, let's carry on. Guys, as you can see, it's starting to get quite dark now, so I want to try and get around to the front of the site and have a good look around and see what other cars we've got here. Stu's just having a little look in this shed. Yeah, all the steel wheels are kept in here. God, there's hundreds, isn't there? There's some big old wellers down there.
Yeah.
Look at the dish on those, they're huge. My God.
Check out the other side here, it's got all the all those doors and things in there.
Has it?
Yeah.
See, a lot of this stuff could probably be saved.
Wait, there's that much stuff here, it's just unreal.
Look at the front end of that car there.
It's a caddy, that is.
It's, oh, yeah.
That front end.
God, yeah, it's just full of doors, isn't it? Look. Unbelievable.
People are dying,
eh? Yeah, I know. That's what I said earlier. There's so many people that are crying for stuff like this. And it's just sat here doing nothing. Look at this, look.
Some of these containers got some awesome bloody parts in
them. Oh, yeah. That's cheap. Turkey, 10p, with salad, 95p.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see that.
What?
Yeah, that's old.
It is, isn't it?
95p.
Cheap as you like, isn't it?
Fucking nice, have one there.
Wow. My dinner sorted. So we're just coming up to the big water tower, which appears to be a storage place for a lot of the parts here. Oh, nearly went down a hole there. Those seats look comfy. Oh, look at the old bike. Oh my God, that is so cool. There's a big straight six down there, look.
There's quite a few behind here too.
Oh yeah, there is. Well, yeah, you'd expect there'd be loads of blocks in there. There's loads. Look at the size of that lump there, look. Another straight six. It's huge. Whoa, what the hell's that? Oh, I just had a bit of a freak out then.
With spider?
Nah, these bloody things that stick to your legs, they're horrible.
Careful, man. That's dodgy, dangerous as fuck that is.
This bike's pretty cool. What's it called? A Galera. It's a pretty cool little thing. I reckon that's probably from the 80s. Look at that, it's still got the key in the ignition. Can't really see the dials too, but oh, it's 37,560 miles. Quite a lot for a bike, actually. This has been used well. What's that say on there? What's behind, what's in front won't. Oh, there's obviously a word missing there. All right, let's go check out some more. It's getting really dark now. Okay, so we're back outside the water tower. Just having a walk around the other side to the other bit that I haven't looked around yet. Ooh. You're out there. You crazy. What's the view like?
Lad is
round
the side,
if
you
want to
join us.
No, I might pass on that. I don't like heights. Yeah, that's a little bit sketchy, that ladder. Ooh. Especially trying to hold a camera and a torch. Ah, Stu's over there. I mean, just stand back for a minute and take this in. Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, about 12 cars in this row. 12 cars in that one row. Row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, maybe 12 or 13 rows just on this little bit here. Every single one of these cars is American. This is so unbelievable. Yeah, guys, I'm not going to do this because I don't really have time at the moment, but Q438UGL. Someone please do a reg check on that car and see if there's any history to when that was potentially left here. I'm guessing it's been here that long, it's not even going to be on the system. This is a pretty cool thing. No idea what it is, but it looks pretty cool. Oh, look at that sunset over there. I don't know if you can see the sky, how red it is. Shame we missed that, I bet that was really cool. Now look at this, guys. These cars are actually buried under the mud.
Is
there a Trans Am? Oh, these brambles are doing my head in. Ugh. Oh, look, just all these cars are just buried under the mud. Oh, God, look at
just
that. Yeah, you can just see them, yeah. Oh, what a shame, isn't it? Oh, unbelievable. Absolutely incredible. Still got a front grille in there. To be fair, there's not really a lot worth saving on it. Maybe the glass in that mirror. That's probably about it, to be honest. But the tail lights look pretty cool.
I've got one set. No, I've got two sets.
Oh yeah, there is two sets. Yeah, I didn't even see that other one. I don't know if I can get around here. There's a Cadillac there, look.
Oh, yeah, Caddy, yeah. Oh. Lagniappe, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. That is so cool. I love the twin rear head, the rear lights. They just look so good, don't they?
I think it's just like twin headlights on.
Yeah, yeah.
The sound is just lovely.
Absolutely.
Tail lights and front lights. Aggression
at the moment. It is, yeah, yeah. So we're just walking past this car. We've noticed this sticker, which was on the window, and it looks like a lion. It's got something National Park, but we don't know what it is. Ugh, little finger.
Does it say State National Park?
Honestly, I can't read it. It's really hard. But there's definitely a picture of a lion on there. Something.
We don't have national parks in the UK, no. It's always American and national park.
Guys, if any of you guys in America are watching this and you know what this is, please just pop it in the comments below. We'd love to know. We haven't got a clue what car it's on. What's left of it? Could be anything.
I'll just literally say Dodge, Chrysler, Chevrolet.
Yeah, it's got to be one of the seven. Other. Called the sinks there. Someone's obviously piled them up for a scrap run and never gone to the scrapyard. Hey, what's that silver car there? That looks cool. Jesus Christ, nearly fell over then. What is that? Do you know, it's been here that long, you can't even read the badges, can you?
Look at those traces here, bro.
Oh, what is it?
Well, it's come round, haven't it, mate? We'll get the cord today.
YJF406S. Look, there's something in the back of that. I don't know if it's like a heat shield or something. God, just look how rotten it is. It's such a shame.
It looks like Buick or...
I can see the steering wheel, but I can't. Oh, Chevrolet, yeah. Yeah. It's a Chevy of some sort. It's got those old pinstripes on the side of the door still. I look around the front. God, it's so dark in here now. Yeah, look, what's that there? V6 3.2 litre.
Yeah, I've rubbed the badge off. Can you see what it says? Did it say Chevy, did it?
Chevy, yeah. Oh, yeah, Monza. It's a Monza.
Chevy Monza?
Yeah.
Mate.
Chevy Monza. Oh, my God.
Chevy Monza.
This is unbelievable, isn't it? They look like Weller wheels on that.
Monte Carlo. You ever seen Training Day?
Yeah.
Monte Carlo.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Just look at that.
Mate, have you seen the tyres?
Yeah.
Had a meaty engine.
Yeah, I know. They're huge, aren't they? Don't even think you're going to be able to... No chance, I'm not even going to bother. Have a look at the engine, you just can't see it.
No, you can't
see it. There's no bonnet on there, I don't think.
This has got lots of Monte Carlos in here. There's a lot of Monte Carlos.
Look at that massive tree growing up between the cars there. I mean, just look at that tree, how tall it is, right? I should say that it takes like 20, 30, maybe 40 years for a tree to grow that tall. Oh, you know, like, have these cars been really, really been here that long? I think they have. That looks cool. It looks quite creepy, actually.
Oh, it does there, doesn't it?
Yeah. Really creepy.
It looks like the front end of a Woody.
It does, doesn't it? Yeah. Got these bumpers here, look. USA, wow. AFE.
It's like you're doing a different video, it's no longer the same video.
No. Okay, guys, so we are now up at the top end of this site. And Stu says this is the best part. Something very special lies around this corner. And I can just about see the back end of it. Oh, it has got cherry bombs. So guys, probably one of the best cars here. Chevy Impala. Just look at this thing. It's got cherry bombs. Two cherry bombs. This thing must sound like a thunderstorm. It really must. Apparently, it's open. So I'm going to have a quick look inside. Oh. Look at this. 79,000 miles on it.
Do you know this thing starts up?
I reckon it would.
Just
look at that, it's like a sofa, isn't it?
Yeah, bench seat, mate.
Honestly, they're just so comfortable.
You can sit there, your girl can sit next to you.
Yeah.
You are a major girl.
Yeah.
King of the road. And also, it's brilliant for lying down because you've got enough room to play.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah. For the drive-throughs. Oh, incredible. Right, shut the door back up on it. Still got the original warning sticker on the window, look.
That's unreal.
Just gonna have a quick look at the front of it as well. God, it's such a big car. It really is. What a find, though. I mean, this is surrounded by even more motorbikes. I mean, everywhere you look, there's an old motorbike. There's two over there. There's an Aprilia just over on the other side. The engine's still in it, isn't it?
The engine?
Yeah, the engine's still in it.
I bet you should turn over, you know.
That's incredible. Absolutely incredible. We've got another motorbike just there. Pontiac Trans Am. There's another motorbike there. I reckon these are the sort of bikes that American pickers would be interested in. Oh, have a quick look at these. Look at the seat on this one. What an amazing little bike. A tiny little engine, literally puny little engine. Have a quick look from the front. Oh, squeeze past. Wow. Nothing inside there, sadly. Do you know what? I love these cars. Absolutely beautiful things. They're so big, though. Right, well, I think we're pretty much done. I mean, we are complete darkness now. So we're going to have to try and find our way back through the forest in a minute. But what an absolutely incredible location this has been. Right, guys, we are back at the car now. It's time for us to make a move. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. Please go and check out the Instagram, which is the Beard Explorer _. Also, go and check out the Facebook page. Like always, I'll put all the pictures on Facebook, telling the best of Instagram. I will link the other guys in the description below, including my main man who's up there, shining the light down on me. And we will see you on the next Explore soon.
Sorted.